Brad hasn't done a great deal of comedy before this, and he's hilarious in it. How did you coax his funny bone?
You stab me?
I will ruin your life the way you ruin mine.
Dude, I don't even know you.
You know, I really didn't have to. I think he was itching. His funny bone must have been itching. He was excited to jump on board. I think we made this at the height of the pandemic, and everyone was, it was sort of uncertain times. And as Brad puts it, you know, it was a really good escape from, you know, the uncertainty of this world. And so we all got together and had a laugh, and he was all about leaning into the laughs.
And as Brad's five-time former stuntman, how would you describe Brad's skills?
No, Brad is an incredibly physically talented actor, and he can pull off a lot of stuff, and he is the first one to jump in there and really deliver as good as it gets in an action sequence. And the only time I ever really had to do anything for Brad in all of those years as a stunt performer, a lot of it was like rehearsing and setting up the stunts that he could execute unless it was really going to hurt. And then I had to do it.
Aaron and Brian are hilarious. What led you to come up with the notion of them being twins?
Remember those two wackos from the Bolivia job?
The twins?
Yeah, not so sure they're twins.
You know, it was something that was in the book. And then something that Zach Olkowitz, the author, had came up with in the adaptation to make them obviously a bit different ethnicities. We thought it was a funny. And then I took it to the next level, and it's like, well, I know we're playing being subversive that they're not really twins and they're not really brothers, but what if we end up finding out that they actually are? And isn't that more fun and emotional? So we just, you know, kept adding the layers of that, the mythos of those characters. And it was really fun.
I understand Brad did about 95% of his own stunts in this. Mm-hmm. What were the most difficult ones?
Well, most of the action in the movie is really fighting action. And so it was really something that's in Brad's wheelhouse. You know, we'd done on our movies together, Troy, he did epic fight scenes, you know, that we rehearsed for months. And Mr. and Mrs. Smith, there's a lot of fighting action. So Brad was really apt to do the action in this movie. And that was some of the harder stuff. There's some wire work where we're flying the doubles outside of the train and like things that you would do, you would use a stunt performer for no matter who the actor was. And so, but all of it, all in all, it was mostly Brad.
David, you've worked with so many different leading action men, you know, Ryan Reynolds, Dwayne Johnson, to name just a few, Keanu Reeves. What made you decide that you wanted Brad to star in this? Because I could see any one of those guys in the role.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I think, look, I wanted to find something to do with Brad, and I'd always hoped that we could land on a script that we both saw sort of the brilliance in. But Ladybug, he was my first choice for Ladybug, and he came to mind when I read it. You know, I just thought it would be fun for him to create this sort of underdog, completely relatable hero, you know, has a Mr. Magoo sensibility. And, you know, again, he's leaning into his comedy chops. And so it was my first call, and I really now can't see anyone else ever bringing Ladybug to life. He's made another iconic role like he always does.
Sandra Bullock's voice in this is, of course, unmistakable. You don't even need to see her to know that it is her. But I was wondering, what was your thinking in casting such a leading lady and an icon in that role?
I think you might be forgetting what you do for a living. Take the gun.
Every job I do, somebody dies. I'm not that guy anymore.
Some conflicts require a gun.
Well, I think part of it is like, you know, we're making a big summer movie, and we want to do everything we can to make the experience, like stack the deck for the experience of the audience. And Sandy just has, you're right, this iconic voice and a calming voice, but she also has this impeccable comedic timing. You know, she's a brilliant comedian, and it was having a level of her talent to support Brad and his comedic endeavors was like a gift. And so for her to come on board and voice the, you know, Maria on the phone, and then, you know, show up when she does as a, you know, extended cameo was really a great thing.
I was curious, actually, in all of your career as an elite stuntman, did you ever work with Australia's Nash Edgerton?
Of course. Nash and I go way back, and we worked with each other on the Matrix sequels. So oh. I was down in Australia for about a year working on those two films, and we became pretty close, and we're still friends. We keep in touch. And I think Nash is a really fun and creative and inspiring filmmaker. And I love his work.
Emmett, Where's the briefcase?
Oh, it's not shit. It was just here.
We are right on schedule.
Everything that's ever happened to you.
This is gonna sting, bitch!
Oh. Has led you here. Fate.